I'm in some great position and working hard because I take a great amount of personal credit for that, of course. As a little boy, Maddie had no choice but to be surrounded by great music. If it wasn't getting a solid education about the Beatles at home, she'd have my more than passing interest in them. He was out with me shopping at JB Hi-Fi every week, or sometimes twice or more, picking up the latest McCartney solo album, Beatles repackaged, yes, they're still doing it, Natalie Merchant, Metallica, and the Living In CDs, and any number of other wonderful things that they were coming out of the time. And yes, you did hear right, Metallica and the Living In. Yeah. I was buying it. And Maddie's picked up the man, which is great. We also often went to record fairs and collectors' fairs, and I think that's rubbed opposite too, because Maddie's got a bit of a passion for vinyl records, even though maybe I don't have a turntable? Not sure. Got one. I haven't got a turntable. Maddie's got one. How the times have changed. Regrettably, I've never played a musical instrument, but as you're all aware, Maddie is a terrific drummer. He's played heaps of awesome shows with the Quarters over the past 12 to 18 months. And I have to tell you, if you haven't seen the Quarters live in concert, do yourself a huge favour. They're bloody great. And of course, Maddie has worked with JB Hi-Fi for several years. As a young boy, I also took Maddie to quite a few car racing events at Sandown Park. We saw all the top drivers of the day, you know, Peter Brock and Dick Johnson and all those sort of guys. But so far, he hasn't taken up motor racing, so I'm not sure about the other thing. Bron's also got a strong interest. Turn the page. In music, surprisingly enough. She's a fantastic singer, and again, when Bron performs another gig, you must be there. It's been a while, Bron. Girls are extremely rare in the Armstrong clan. Myself and my three brothers have only produced one Armstrong girl, and that was 40 plus years ago. So we're very pleased to welcome Bron on board, to say the least. My brothers aren't here tonight. Evan lives in Hong Kong and Jeff had another commitment that he couldn't break to be here, and my eldest brother Rob would be here in person if he could, but I know he's here in spirit and looking down very proudly on you both, as we all are. It's magnificent that my mum Uriel, Maddie's Nana, is here tonight. Mum's coming up to 90 this year. Where are you, Mum? I can see you in the back blocks. Put your hand up, Mum. Maddie's Nana. And I must tell you, it was a thrill for us all when we got the wonderful engagement news on Christmas Day. It really made the day much more special. We're all very impressed with the detailed planning and delivery of how and when Maddie actually popped a question to Bron. So romantic. Not quite sure where he gets those skills from.
It's not him.
We may touch on that fiendish plan just a little bit more in a minute. Because it involved pretty much the whole Venables family, and Harry, I believe, was accomplice to this fiendish plan. Anyway, as I said, they've been together for nearly 8 years, having met at Wheelers since secondary college, and it's great to see so many friends from Wheelers and Chelsea Park here today. Maddie and Bron are a great couple. They're doing and will continue to do great things together. I'll say it again, and I'm sure I speak on behalf of everybody in the room. We're thrilled to have that you've both committed to each other in marriage, and you've definitely got our love and support. Yeah. I'll hand over now to you for a few words, and then it's back to me to toast the happy couple.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you very much for coming for this very auspicious occasion. The engagement of Bron and Maddie. I think I'm a very lucky person. I was born in Australia, I was born in Melbourne. I had parents that nurtured me.
Fabulous younger sister.
Fabulous younger sister, isn't it?
Great sister. Yes.
And then I got super lucky and I married Di. And Di's been a terrific partner, he's a terrific partner to me. And somehow between the two of us, we managed to create two children who grew up to be fabulous adults. And of course, Bron is one of those. What's great about Bron from a parent's point of view is that she makes great decisions. You don't need to worry about Bron, you know, she's never going to get into trouble because she makes great decisions. And you see people in their lives who make bad decisions. And you think about those people and you think, why'd they do that? Bron doesn't do that. So, what would a father look for in a partner for his daughter? I would look for someone who's caring, kind, gentle, and if I can indulge myself, maybe respectful. And Bron's made a great decision because Maddie's all of those things. And I'd really like to thank Carolyn and Greg and David and Leslie for Maddie. And Maddie, I'd really like to welcome you wholeheartedly into our family. Bron had laser eye surgery last year and came home with blindfolds on and a very complicated medication regime, and Maddie looked after her until he had to go to work, and then Diagram looked after her and was presented by Maddie with a very complete set of instructions on exactly how this would happen, which was presented in a very consistent way. So it was clear to us that Maddie really cares for Bron. On Christmas Eve last year, Don and I were about to take Scott to the station, so we get to home, and there was a phone call. Scott got the phone call, and went to the toilet.
I think that should be me.
No, not the phone, no, just the toilet. And we waited, and the doorbell rang, and it was Maddie. And Maddie doesn't often come around without Bron, so this is a bit unusual. And after we exchanged a few pleasantries, Maddie eventually said that he wanted to ask her our hand in him asking Bron to marry me. Is that quite right?
No, asking you for her hand.
But then it's a funny thing. He said, I'm going to need your help to get it there. And we thought, after 7 years, man, I didn't need much help. But it turned out that he wanted to propose to her in a very special place. He's thrilled up. If you've watched the pictures, you'll have seen Maddie proposing under a bridge that's at St Kilda, and we had to get Bron to St Kilda without her knowing why she was going there, so we took her on a surprise trip to St Kilda. And surprise, surprise, Maddie popped out of the bushes. So I hope you're all having a good time, and that's enough for me.
The Armstrong and Venables family, and all your friends here and afar, let's raise a glass to congratulate Maddie and Bron and wish them all the best for a wonderful future. To Maddie and Bron.
Maddie and Bron.
So, that ends the formal part of proceedings. You can kick your heels off.
Just one more thing, there's a photo booth over here. You just come and line yourself in groups and get a photo taken. They'll all be nothing in the book.
Thanks to everyone who's helped put tonight together. There's been so many hands at work and so many big and small details, and they all came together and we're just thrilled with how it's turned out. So thank you all. Thank you for being a part of our lives and our relationship, and you've all meant a lot to us through the years. That's why we've invited you here. And we hope to keep in touch with all of you throughout the years and our marriage and our lives together. I don't know what else to say. Thank you for the beautiful speeches. I wish we had filmed them, but that's okay. I don't want to remember. And Yes, please eat the food and drink the drinks and have a good night and come and talk to us.
Yay, Ron.
And try the deal as well. Excuse that.